We're back with our analysts. And Jeffrey Toobin, the Attorney General Bill Barr, he's all of a sudden giving some interviews to the Wall Street Journal, Fox News. I want to play for you an exchange he had with Bill Hemmer of Fox News earlier in the day talking about all of this. Listen to this.
The president calls this a witch hunt. He calls it a hoax. Would you agree with that?
Well, as I've said, if you were the president, I think you would view it as a witch hunt and a hoax, because at the time he was saying he was innocent and that he was being falsely accused.
Are you comfortable using those words? Witch hunt? Hoax?
I use what words I use, and it was an investigation, but I think if I had been falsely accused, I'd be comfortable saying it was a witch hunt.
All right, Jeffrey, what do you think?
I was amazed by that interview in the one in the Wall Street Journal. It turns out the attorney general is Sean Hannity, and Sean Hannity is the attorney general. I mean, every talking point from Fox News gets repeated. That, you know, he has no problem with calling the FBI, which works for him, a hoax and a witch hunt. I mean, and you know, Donald Trump cooperated fully, even though he didn't talk to the investigation. I mean, I just found it an absolutely astonishing couple of interviews.
What did you think, Mark Preston?
I mean, look, it's really hard to top what Jeffrey just said right there, especially when you look at the attorney general, and he's the one going out there saying, I'm the impartial one. I'm going to be the person who's going to oversee this investigation into Hillary Clinton, and we're going to go back there because we think that is so important. At the same time, he just wants to dismiss what's right in front of us. I mean, it's clear that he is not playing an even hand right there, and it is quite apparent.
Look, I think people who know Bill Barr, nobody really believes that he is going to rig whatever this outcome is for Donald Trump. I do think that what you're hearing from him is skepticism that he had before he became attorney general, which he apparently still has. Now, look, by this time, this is an attorney general who could have been briefed on everything. I mean, I'm a little befuddled as to why he doesn't have all the answers already, because, I mean, he could have had somebody bring him everything and take a weekend or 2 weeks or whatever to read everything about what this investigation, how it began. And so I think some of the things that he's used, some of the words he's using, I wonder there must be something else at play here. Is he trying to perhaps bank some points with the president? This is a president who's very transactional. Is he trying to, put himself in a place so that in the future when he has bad news for the president, he is in a better place for that? I'm not sure, but, I'm not ready to jump to those conclusions just yet.
Caitlin, clearly the president is loving what he's hearing from the attorney general, especially his decision to launch a brand new investigation into the origins of the Russia probe.
Yeah, the president and his allies wanted their own special counsel to look at that. Bill Barr didn't go that far. He had just assigned a U.S. attorney to look at it, so it's not the same. They don't have the same level of independence that a special counsel did, but he is following essentially what the president wants. The question here is, Bill Barr has said, even though he's making comments like that it's okay if he calls it a witch hunt because he says the president was falsely accused. But the thing is, he's couching other language and he's being more hesitant, saying, I don't know that there was bias, but I have a lot more questions than I have answers, and I want to find out those answers. You look at the president's Twitter feed, the president is already prejudging the outcome of this investigation and believes, yes, they were biased against me. So the question for Bill Barr is going to be, if he does get to the end of this and the FBI did act appropriately, then what is he going to say to the president?
Even without an investigation, Jeffrey Toobin, the president has already concluded the result. My campaign for president, he tweeted, was conclusively spied on. Nothing like this has ever happened in American politics. A really bad situation. Treason means long jail sentences, and this was treason.
Treason, you know, a crime that under American law is punishable by the death penalty. So, I mean, just keep that in mind. I mean, we are so far from how presidents have traditionally behaved in this country. I mean, you know, he's the head of the Justice Department, which is the head of the FBI, and he is calling the leadership of the FBI, James Comey, Andrew McCabe, all these people, he's calling them treasonous. This has not happened. Richard Nixon didn't call his enemies in the government, much less with these kind of accusations. I mean, you know, it's just tweets and we're sort of used to it by now, but I think we need to maintain the capacity to be outraged.
You know, the mere simple actions that he decided to interpret the Mueller report and present it to Congress in a way that really did confuse us for many weeks, A, and B,
it was misleading. I mean,
misleading, yeah. misleading, and then deciding to go and say, look, we are going to look into Hillary Clinton, and we're going to see if there was some problems with that, and we're also going to be looking at to see if this was politically motivated. I don't think anybody has a problem to looking into the federal government to make sure that our folks, that our law enforcement folks, are not doing stuff for politically partisan purposes. But the fact of the matter is, what he's doing right now is creating a big smokescreen and trying to create more chaos and confusion.
I think the Attorney General is not doing any favors for himself with some of the language. I think he could be doing all of these things without saying some of these words, using the words no collusion repeatedly in his press conference, for instance. I think without those things, and he could be accomplishing the exact same things without using those words. I think without a doubt, that's part of the issue here.
And that's what the White House is sticking by. They're saying this is not someone who had a personal relationship like Jeff Sessions did with the president right. before he became Attorney General. So he's not going to jump in front of a train for the president and put his reputation on the line. But then when you look at that and then what he's saying, you know, I'm fine with calling this a witch hunt. That's where he creates problems for himself with Democrats on Capitol Hill, who it helps further their talking point that he's just doing what the president wants.